About our relation with the Palestinians and our relation with the Israelis. Usually I say among Palestinians we are privileged. We have a unique position, well accepted, respected. If you go around now, you find some brothers married to Palestinian girls, you find Palestinians married to sisters from the quarter. I never felt among Palestinians discriminated because of my color. While with the Israelis, it's a totally different issue. In the Israeli side, they call us Kushi, nigger, Sambo, in a very insulting way. By the way, if you take the Israel society, you have various Jewish groups. The most discriminated today are our people. The black Jews from Ethiopia.
Yes.
Late in the 80s, there was a campaign of donation of blood. They went like other Israelis, donated blood. At the end of the day, all blood donated by them were thrown to the garbage.
Yes.
6 years ago, there was a big scandal in this country. A sister, a black Ethiopian sister, member of the parliament, went to the hospital to donate blood. No way. And you should see when there is a demonstration of our people, for example, in Tel Aviv, the brutality of the police they use against them. It's the way in the USA with our people. Now, I am a second generation, I born here. My father is from Chad. We are four groups, the first generation. Chad, Nigeria, Senegal, Sudan. Our fathers came as pilgrims from Mecca to Jerusalem. Stayed here, began to marry from the Palestinian side. So for that, we, the second, the third, the fourth generation, we say we are Afro-Palestinians. I think your presence here is very important. Personal experience, then to deliver a message when you go back home. And when I meet some brothers and sisters, I work as an alternative group guy. Unfortunately, most of my clients, blonde, blue eyes. When I see a group of my people going with an Israeli group guy, I intend to let them listen. I say to my clients, now we are heading to the African quarter. Believe me, none of them dares to look at me. None of them. Yesterday I was following the news here. I saw the conference of the AIPAC, the Zionist lobby in the USA. Unbelievable when I saw some sisters, brothers cheering, applauding in a very hysterical way. And if I meet some brothers, this is, I said to them, look, brother, don't illusion yourself. Israelis don't like you or respect you. They like your great money. That's the main issue for the Israelis. For example, take Obama. Obama, I say about him all the time, he's a coconut. In spite of all the services he did to the Israelis, they don't like him. During the campaign of the election of this idiot, Donald Trump, they were saying the Israelis, he's fascist, races. But today, he's together with Netanyahu on the same bed. Birds of feather work together. And you Americans, you have a very serious problem with your various presidents. Let's begin with Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton was a man who has the ability to control the whole world, but has no ability to control the lower part of his body. Issue of Monica. Then came Bush the son. He has a very serious problem in the upper part of the body. Today, you have a president who has a serious problem up and down. So, I am really very proud that I am meeting people, my people. And don't feel as tourists. Don't feel like stupid tourists. You are not tourists. You are coming back to your original homeland. We are deeply rooted in this land. Look at this picture. I'll explain to you now. The man holding the rope of the camel is the Caliph Umar bin Khattab, the third man after Prophet Muhammad. But look on the man riding the camel. This is brother Bilal ibn Rabah from Ethiopia. He was the main muaddin of Prophet Muhammad, who used to call for the prayer. When Prophet Muhammad died, he said, I will never call for prayer anymore. But when he came to Jerusalem, Umar bin Khattab said to him, Bilal, call for the prayer. And he called for the prayer. So, you are not tourists. You are not like those stupid brothers and sisters following the Israeli tour guide like a cattle of goats. Oh, lovely, everything is nice. Even taking pictures with the soldiers, I see some of them. Which is really provocative for Palestinians. And by the way, now, if you go around among Palestinians, believe me, unbelievable, the hospitality you get from Palestinians. Palestinians say, the Afro-Americans, we Palestinians, we are in the same boat. We are oppressed and they are oppressed. Now, if you have any question, please don't hesitate. This is a good opportunity for you. Okay, the man behind you, over there, look over there, the picture. That's Chairman Yasser Arafat. I don't know if you have heard.
Oh, yeah.
Who used to be the president of the Palestinian state. I am together with him. That was in 1998 in his compound in Ramallah. Now, why we are so accepted and respected by Palestinians? It's because of our contribution in the national struggle. For example, the first Palestinian female to be put in Israeli jails came from the African war. Second generation, the father from Nigeria, the mother from Jericho. She was sentenced 30 years, of which she passed 11 years, deported, she came back with Arafat in 1994. Today, she is the chief of the Palestinian police female in the Palestinian Authority. Now look at this picture. Denzel Washington. That's my picture when I was 18 years old. I was arrested, sentenced 20 years because of my political activities. I passed 17 years from 1968 up to 1985. I was released in a big exchange of prisoners. Yeah. When I came out of prison, I began to work with some Israelis as a journalist. Israelis, progressive Israelis, anti-settlers, anti-occupation. I went on working as journalist until 1991 with the Israelis because of the person I have married to back to the Palestinian side. In 1994, when the Palestinian Authority came, I said, I can't work anymore as a journalist. I have a problem. I was totally against Oslo Accords of Norway, and I was very critical towards the Palestinian Authority, the corruption, you see. And I don't know if it is a bless or a curse. More sharp than the Indian pepper. So I said, I can't work as a journalist. I began to work as alternative tour guide. Alternative tour guide to take your clients to raise their political awareness about what's really happening around. Europe, it's, as you say, bullshit. We in Arabic, we say kara.
Kara.
Now, please, once again, sisters, brothers, don't hesitate. If you have any question,